हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू रॉयल पैलेस पीयू कॉलेज ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी शैल स्टार्ट विद द ओके एक्सरसाइज 1.1 ऑफ द चैप्टर रिलेशनल फंक्शन, दैट इज द टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू रिफ्लेक्सिव, सिमेट्रिक एंड ट्रांसिटिव। ओके, दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक वी शैल स्टार्ट नाउ। ओके डियर फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल। वॉट इज दैट एग्जाम्पल हियर? शो दैट द रिलेशन आर इन द सेट आर। R means here the set of all real numbers it is, okay, defined by R equal to A comma B such that A is less than equal to B square. A is less than equal to B square, okay. B square is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. This particular topic we shall see. Neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive, okay. Let us observe here. Okay friends, so here what do you mean by but reflexive here? Okay, here he had said us to show that it is not reflexive, not reflexive. But here it is defined as, R is defined as A is less than equal to B square. For example, okay, first of all, reflexive means what? Reflexive. Now here, for this particular set of all real numbers it is given. We can't write this set, okay, in the set builder form R in roster form. That means set of all real numbers means we are having infinite number of okay numbers here, therefore we can't write in the roster form. So here what we can do here, in generally we can write how, since we have to show that it is not reflexive. Not reflexive means what here? If, for example, we shall take here 2 comma 2. What is the value for 2 comma 2 here? What is less than equal to 2 comma 2? Or else you can take it as 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2. Okay, 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2. So here 1 by 2 does not belongs to R. Why 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2 does not belongs to R? Here 1 by 2 is a real number here. Okay, 0.5 is a real number. Now why do we say because okay, what we can tell the reason? Because 1 by 2 less than equal to, what is the condition? B square. 1 by 2 A comma B. 1 by 2 less than equal to 1 by 2 square means 1 by 4. Since 1 by 2, that is 0.5, it is greater than what it is? 0.5 is greater than 0.4. okay, 1 by 4 means what it is? 0.25. okay, so here it is not possible, or because 1 by 2 is not less than equal to 1 by 4. Therefore what we can tell here, the given R is not reflexive. Dear friends, to say it is a reflexive, we may have many reasons, but to say that it is not reflexive, only one reason is sufficient. Similarly for other thing also, similar for other condition also. Now we shall look on to the next, that is symmetry. Okay dear friends, pay attention. Now what do you mean by symmetry here? Symmetry means what? Actually the definition of symmetry is, if A comma B belongs to R, okay, that implies what we should have? B comma A should also be belongs to R. If it is there and if it is not there, that means it is not reflexive. Okay, it is not symmetry. Sorry, it is not symmetry. Let us take some of the examples related to this particular thing. That is, A is less than equal to B square. What examples we can take, dear friends, here? For example, here, if we take here 2 comma 4. Okay, if we take 2 comma 4. What do we have here? It is symmetry. Okay, what we have belongs to R. Okay, 2 comma 4 belongs to R. That implies, does 4 comma 2, 2 comma 4 belongs to R means what, dear friends? So here, okay, or else you can take it as 2 comma 6. Okay, that will be still more easy. 2 comma 6 belongs to R means what? 2 is less than equal to 6 square. According to definition, A is less than equal to B square. 2 is less than equal to 6 square. That means what is the value here? 2 is less than equal to 36. And it is right also, because 36 is larger here. Okay. Similarly here, that implies here, does 6 comma 2. 6 comma 2 belongs to R here. Does 6 comma 2 belongs to R? Question mark. Why I'm telling? Because 6, according to the condition, A is less than equal to B square we have. That means 6 is less than equal to here, that is 2 square. 2 square means what is the value here? That is 4. Does 6 is less than equal to 4? It is wrong here. It is wrong. Therefore, what we can say here is it does not belongs to R. Okay, dear friends, 2 comma 6 belongs to R, but 6 comma 2 does not belongs to R. Therefore, what we can say here? R is not symmetry. R is not symmetry. Now let us take one more example related to it. What example we can take now? So now the last one, that is transitive. Now the last option is transitive. Transitive means what option we can take? Transitive. So now transitive means what we can take? Example here. For example, A is less than equal to what we have? B square. A is less than equal to B square. For example, if you take here 3, 2 belongs to R. Okay, what do you mean by transitive? First of all, that we shall check here. Transitive means, okay dear friends, pay attention. Transitive means A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R. If these two should belongs to R, these two should also belongs to R, that implies what we can say? A comma C should also belongs to R. Then only we say it is transitive. A comma B should be there in R, B comma C should be there in R, then A comma C, the first and the last here, should belongs to R here. Now since we have to show that it is not transitive, okay, not transitive, if I take 3 comma 2 belongs to R, 3 comma 2 means what we'll have? 3 is less than equal to, what is the condition we have here? A is less than equal to B square. That means here this is the value for A and it is B. 2 square means 4. Yes, 3 is less than equal to 4. It is true only. Therefore, it belongs to R here. Okay. And we can take here 2, 1.5. Okay. 2, 1.5 belongs to R. 2, 1.5 belongs to R means what? 2. Okay. 2 is less than equal to 1.5 square. That is 2.25 here. That is also right here. Okay. These two belongs to R. Dear friends, pay attention here. 3, 2 belongs to R. That means it satisfies the condition here. A is less than equal to B square. Similarly, 2, 1.5 also belongs to R and it satisfies the condition. But that implies the first and the last, that is 3, 1.5. Does it belongs to R here? Does it belongs to R? Yes. How we can check here? 3 is less than equal to 1.5. 3 is less than equal to 1.5 means 2.25. Is it correct? It is not correct here. Therefore, we say here it does not belongs to R. Okay. It does not satisfy the condition here R. Okay. It does not satisfy A is less than equal to B square. Therefore, we say here, therefore that implies R is transitive. R is not transitive. R is not transitive. Okay. Okay, dear friends, that is our first question. Okay, that is our first question. This question will be asked for 3 marks question in your examination. Okay, now we shall move on with the next question. What is the next question we are having? This question was asked for 3 marks in the year June 2017, dear friends. That means supplementary examination. Okay, supplementary 2017 Karnataka State PU Board. Now what he has given the question here? Check whether the R defined in the set A equal to, define the set A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as R equal to A comma B such that B equal to A plus 1 is reflexive, symmetric or transitive. Just we have to check whether this given R is reflexive or symmetric or transitive. So before that, it is a very simple question. Before starting with this question, this particular question I will write in the set builder. Okay, already set builder form is given. I will write in the roster form. In the previous problem, it was not possible because the set itself was a set of all real numbers. It was here the limited values of the set has been given. Now what we can write here? For example, A. If I take A is equal to 1, what is the B value here? B value means here A plus 1. That means here A plus 1 means 1 plus 1, 2. Okay, next one. If I take A as a 2, 2 plus 1, that is 3. Then if I take value as 3, what we get? 3 means 3 plus 1 is 4. Similarly, if I take 4 value, 4 plus 1, that is 5. And similarly, if I take 5, what values we get? That is 5 plus 1, 6. Now we can't take the next values. What we can take, why we can't take the next values? For example, if you take 6 here, 6 plus 1, 7 values will be there. 7, it is not there in the set. Okay, why? Because A comma B should always belong to the set A here. Therefore, we can't write this set. Okay, now in this particular relation R, it is very easy for us to find out whether it is reflexive, symmetry or transitive. First of all, we shall start with reflexive. Dear friends, pay attention here. It is a very, very simple question and asked in your question paper. Reflexive means what? Here we should have 1 comma 1 belongs to R. 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3, 4 comma 4 should always belongs to R. But we don't have anything value like that. Okay, so here A comma A does not belongs to R. Therefore, R is not reflexive. Not reflexive, why? Instead you can write A comma A or 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, okay, does not belongs to R. You can write 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3, 4 comma 4, 5 comma 5 and 6 comma 6 does not belongs to R. You can write in this particular manner. Okay, next comes the symmetry. Symmetry. What is a symmetry now? Just we can take a simple example. That is, if we have, since here 1 by 2, 1 comma 2 belongs to R we have. Okay, if we have 1 comma 2, therefore that implies 2 comma 1. Do we have anything like 2 comma 1 here in this set R here, relation R? We don't have 2 comma 1. Does not belongs to R. That means only one condition is sufficient to say that it is not symmetry. Okay, therefore not symmetry. Symmetry. Okay, the last one very important, transitive. Dear students, pay attention regarding the transitive one. Transitive means what? Let us take here 2 comma 3 you can take, or else you can take 1 by 2, nothing wrong. Okay, 2 comma 3 belongs to R. Okay, this is one thing. And anything starting with 3 now, this is 3, the second term starting with 3. Starting with 3, anything is there? Yes, of course. 3 comma 4 is there. 3 comma 4 belongs to R. But the first and the first element of the first order pair and the second element of the second order pair, that is 2 comma 4, does it belongs to R here? Question mark. Okay, does it belongs to R? See here, whether we have any 2 comma 4 here. Dear friends, we don't have anything like 2 comma 4. We don't have anything like 2 comma 4. Therefore, it is does not belongs to R. And it does not satisfy the condition for transitive. Therefore, not transitive. Therefore, not transitive. That means what we have here, that means here the given relation R in the set A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is neither reflexive nor symmetry nor transitive. Okay, dear friends, these are the two examples. Please note, okay, pause the video to note it down. Okay, dear friends, please pause it to note it down. Okay, dear friends, now let us start with the next problem. So here what he has asked, show that the relation R in R, R means what it is? Set of all real numbers defined as R equal to A comma B, A is less than or equal to B. Very similar to previous problem here, A is less than or equal to B is reflexive and transitive, but not symmetric. Now here, what is that? Let us observe here. For example, first one, that is reflexive. Reflexive. Now what is that reflexive here? What does it says? Observe here. A comma A. Reflexive means what it is? A comma A belongs to R, I will tell. Why does A comma A belongs to R? Why? Because if you take R means A means you can take any real number. Set of all any real numbers you can take. A comma A. Because we are having A is less than equal to A we have. Because here A less than equal to A. Less than or equal to. Therefore, what we can say, it is reflexive. Therefore, R is reflexive. You can take anything. 1 comma 1, 2 comma 1, minus 2 comma 2, minus 3 comma 3, 0 comma 0. Any values you can take. Okay. Either it will be less than or equal to. 100% is equal to is also sign there. Therefore, it is reflexive. Next comes our symmetry. Now what he has said here, we have to show that it is reflexion transitive but not symmetry, not symmetry. So now here, now how we can tell it is not symmetry? Why? Because here, let what we can take here, 1, 3 belongs to R. If I take, okay dear friends, observe here, 1, 3 belongs to R. Here 1, 3 belongs to R means what? It is 1 is less than equal to 3. That implies, according to definition, A is less than equal to B. 1 is less than or equal to, obviously 1 is less than 3, but that implies 3, 1 does it belongs to R? Why? Because 3, whether it is less than or equal to 1 here? No, 3 is greater than 1 here. It is not satisfying. Therefore, it does not belong to R here. It does not belong to R. Therefore, what we can say? R is not symmetric. Okay. Now, the last one. What is the last one? The last one is transitive. Transitive means what? Transitive. Now here, what does the term transitive means? Transitive means what here? If suppose we are having A comma B belongs to R, okay, and B comma C should also belongs to R. Here A, small letter A, B, C are all real numbers. For example, A, B, you can take A comma B means here, if you take 1, 2, or else you can take any value, nothing wrong in that. 1, 2, we can observe that 1 is less than 2 here. Okay, right? Then here, starting with B, that is 2, 3. If I take 2, 3 means here 1, 2 belongs to R, 2, 3 belongs to R. That implies here 1, 3 should also belongs to R, because 1 is less than or equal to 3 here. 1 is less than or equal to 3. That implies what we can see here. Okay, A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R. That implies A comma C belongs to R here, belongs to R. Therefore, what we can say here? Therefore, R is transitive. Transitive for all A, B, C belongs to the set R. For all A comma C belongs to the set R. What we are telling, A comma B should belongs to R, compulsory. These two are compulsory. If these two are compulsory, then it will happen here. What I'm telling here, A comma B belongs to R is there, and B comma C belongs to R. Already it is there. These two are already there. That implies we can say that A comma C should also belongs to R. You can take a lot of values here. For example, even though you can take here -3, -3, -2, okay, belongs to R, and okay, A comma B belongs to R. -2, -1, it is also belongs to R. Why? Because -2, obviously it is less than -2. Okay, that implies what we can say here? That implies -3, -1 is also belongs to R. Not only these, you can take many other examples also, okay, to say that it is transitive. Okay, dear friends, this is all about the problem. Now we shall move on with the next problem. What is the problem here? It is a very, very important also. Show that the relation R in the set A equal to, show that the relation R in the set A equal to 1, 2, 3 given by R equal to 1, 2 and 2, 1 is a symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. Okay, it is very, very simple. En kotarilli R en kotara namagilri 1, 2 kotidara amale 2, 1 kotarilli amale en kotarilli A andre en kotara namage set kotiranta set en kotara namagili 1, 2, 3 ant kotidar. Okay, the given set is 1, 2, 3 here. Now dear friends, what is the first one? First one is reflexive. Reflexive means what? From the set A here, 1, 1 should be there. Do we have any 1, 1 belongs to R? We don't have it. 1, 1 does not belongs to R. We should also have 2, 2 belongs to R, 3, 3 belongs to R. It is not there in R. Okay, therefore R is not reflexive. Okay, ಇದು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ, 1, 1 ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ, 2, 2 ಈಗಿರಬೇಕು, 3, 3 ಇರಬೇಕು, ಅವು ಎರಡೂ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. Okay, these three are not present here. Therefore, what we say? It is not, does not belong to R. It is not reflexive. Then comes the symmetry. Symmetric. Now, what is a symmetric? Here, we can observe that 1, 2 belongs to R. 1 comma 2 belongs to R means the reverse process of it. That is 2 comma 1 also belongs to R. It is also here. 1 comma 2 is there. The reverse process 2 comma 1 is also R. Therefore, R is symmetric. Symmetric. Therefore, R is symmetric. Okay, dear friends. Now, let us start with the transitive. Transitive. Now, what does it transitive says? Transitive means what? If suppose we have, okay, 1 comma 2 belongs to R is there, and starting with 2, that is 2 comma 1 is also belongs to R. That implies what we should have here? 1 comma 1 belongs to R we should have. But do we have any 1 comma 1 here? We don't have any 1 comma 1. It does not belongs to R. Therefore, R is not transitive. R is not transitive. Therefore, my dear friends, what we can say here? The R is here, the relation R is symmetric, but neither reflexive, not reflexive, and not transitive. Okay, dear friends, please review the videos as much as possible. Okay, please pause the video to note it down. In the next class, we shall start with our remaining problems related to our exercise 1.1. Thank you, friends.